Okay, we are also talking to the Minister of Information and Communication, Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo. Probably he would want to react to what you just said, Ayo. Yes, Alhaji?
Yes, I didn't want to get most of what he said.
Say the last time around, the President sort of pointed fingers at some ministers as being corrupt, but nothing was done. They are still occupying their offices. So he said, he's saying he was disappointed.
Well, of course, this was like a reaction from some members of the public. Of course, what the president believes, and he reiterated that yesterday, that before he took any action, he wanted to make it very clear to the various agencies he spoke to on the 26th of January, that he was watching and that he was aware that there were irregularities taking place, and that once he came up with all the facts available to him, then of course he will take the necessary action. And this was what coordinated to what happened yesterday. Yes, the president has enough information, and like actually he has more information that he's holding it close to his chest, and he wants to be certain that severe action is taken to discourage people from undermining the state itself. Because, Mark, you, Claudia, we have made the point time and again that even though we are talking about poverty, we ourselves as Sierra Leoneans must also contribute towards the development of this country. We must find ways that we can generate the necessary resources to develop this country, to make the roads, to provide electricity, etc., etc. There is no way by which we agitate about development when we do not have a mechanism to properly collect revenue. So this is one thing. So the president is saying, look, we've given you enough notice. We warn you, we have said change your ways. Now some of them did not change their ways, and now the president is suspecting that they are colluding with businessmen to undermine the capacity of NRA to collect revenue. So he has taken this firm action. So whether anybody likes it or not, I've seen government do, this is one of the toughest actions taken by the president in this country.
Ayo, do you agree that this is one of the toughest actions?
Well, it is one of the toughest visible action. I'm sure he's done a lot behind the scenes. It's the first that he's done publicly. But I think the top a few weeks ago when he declared that some of his ministers are corrupt. Because if you come out and publicly say so about the people that you work so closely with, that has got to take a lot of courage. But this is a step in the right direction, and I think the Anti-Corruption Commission has got to do far, far more. They can't be having the president doing the job for them. They've got to start ticking and moving. And of course, bravo to the president, but we want more.
Okay, Ayo, do you think this latest action would deter people from being corrupt?
No, I think corruption is not going to be seeded out or weeded out in one stroke of a president's declaration or a press conference or even the police getting involved in this level of corruption. And it's going to take time. But we've got to start sending the right signals. We've got to have a zero policy towards corruption, where when it's identified, sniffed out, when individuals are seen to be doing so, they're taken out. When departments are seen to be corrupt, they are stopped. And I think this is a step in the right direction. But I'm afraid it's going to take time. We need more. We need the judiciary to be tough. We need the police to be tough in their investigations, and we need the full brunt of the law to be brought against these individuals.
Well, let me go over to Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo. Alhaji, do you think this latest action would make people stop being corrupt?
Well, of course, two things have simply taken place, and which have made some people extremely jittery. The tolerant and accommodating President Ernest Koroma suddenly changed in 24 hours. And has become an extremely uncompromising person in the area of fighting corruption. And he wanted to be there yesterday to discover how tough he sounded and how uncompromising he sounded. So this is what he kept on telling people. This is a man who was quite prepared to embrace everybody so that we all work together. But suddenly we have now pushed him to the point where he thinks that he must change his style, he must be a little bit more tough and uncompromising, even if unfriendly, to achieve his goals. Because for him, he wants to leave a legacy behind, and he wants to retire. And by the time he retires, he will be a young man still, and therefore he would not want corruption to be part of the legacy he's leaving behind. So to answer to your question, yes, Ernest Koroma has taken a very firm position, the president has, and I'm sure that it has driven the point home to make it very, very clear that this kind of nonsense will not be tolerated in this country anymore. And that invoicing has been taking place for the past 30, 40 years, We've fought it time and time again. All this bill of poor declarations, this has been the vogue. Now the president says enough is enough, and we are going to stop encouraging this, and whoever colludes with any businessman to do this will be dealt with severely. And this is what the president thinks should be done. So about the anti-corruption commission, believe me, we are liberal enough. We did not leave them out. Yesterday I spoke to the deputy commissioner and the corruption commission. We said we are going to have this meeting at State House. Could he come in and sit so that he too would have information regarding the action the president is taking? If they were here today, too, can go ahead and do their own thing. But the bottom line is, I think that the message is going down, and this is going to stop some people from undertaking these irregular activities.
Okay, Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo, please continue to stay on the line. And on the line to London, there is Ayo Johnson. Please hold on the line. We want to listen to what our listeners are saying on this subject. And for that, I go over to Lucien Momo. Good morning, Lucien.
In Claudia. Oh, our president, you are a real citizen of this nation. May God continue to guide you from Kombatona, who lives in Kono. Bravo, Papa Ernest. Don't leave any stone unturned. I'm sure this time around, Sierra Leone government is no longer in anybody's pocket. From IB Conte, who lives at Klein Town. Thanks, Alhaji IB Kargbo, for always sacrificing your time to serve Mama Salon. And we hope the president will leave no stone unturned to rip off wicked NRA people for Sierra Leone to thrive. From Abu Jalo, who lives at Masapaka in Kailaun. Bravo, Ichi, for your brave step against these defrauders. And what is the judiciary up to? Because justice delayed is justice denied. From Finda, who lives in Kano. I am supporting the president for his speech indeed. Anyone found guilty, let him sentence him for life. From Aminture, who lives at 33 Majudo Street in Makeni. Many big guns will have to suffer. As long as corruption did exist, and as long as the authority did not change their attitude towards the progress of the nation, the struggle to wipe out corruption will continue. From Mohamed Alpha Jabi, who lives at Blue Zone in Kokwema. Well done, President Koroma. Surely there are more to follow. In Jesus' name, amen. From Jonalo at 55 Sports in Koidu. To connive with an alien against your own country for the reward of money is an unpatriotic, treasonable act. Such people deserve to die. And this one is from Edward Amara, who lives in Kailaun. The final one for now, Claudia. Bravo, President Koroma. Your swift and decisive action yesterday against those economic terrorists is the tip this country has needed for the past three quarters of a century. Keep it up. From Lamin S. Kangi, who lives in Koiru Town, Claudia.
Thank you very much, Lucien. That was Lucien Momo with some of your text messages. Continue to share your thoughts with us. The number is 076-316-735. 076-316-735. I have on the line here in Freetown, Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo, the Minister of Information and Communication. And also on the line to London, I have a Sierra Leonean-born Africa analyst. He's Ayo Johnson. Yes, you're still with us in the program. Let me ask a final question to Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo. We are talking here about 21 containers. Have they all been impounded? Because the president said they must be confiscated to the state.
Well, I'll tell you, of course, when you read the 1991 constitution, you know that whatever statement the executive president makes is law by itself. He has given instructions to the police, the law enforcement agency. He said they should be impounded, so the assumption is that they have been impounded. And Mr. Hussein will not have access to them anymore. And we, if possible, we'll take our television cameras and we'll call the journalists to follow up this matter when I find the time between today and tomorrow. But the important thing is that, yes, the president will not mislead the public. He says they are impounded, and therefore they will be impounded. That is the position.
Okay, Ayo, this practice down there at the Water Key has been going on for decades. It has brought a lot of loss to Sierra Leone, not so?
Yes, yes, it has. It has. Sierra Leone has lost revenue. It has lost credibility. And this action by the president, and more so the, is putting back some level of credibility into the system for people to start having confidence in officials, having confidence in the authority to deliver and to be able to get the goods out without corruption being part of it. So, yes, step in the direction all around.
Okay, well, at this point, I would want to say thank you very much, Ayo, for joining me on the line from London.
Thank you.
He is a Sierra Leonean-born Africa analyst based in the UK. And thank you very much, Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kargbo, for on the program.
Thank you very much, Claudia. Thank you for having me. Thank you very much for having me this morning. Thank you.
You're very welcome, sir.